Identifying outliers using software STATA. In this video, I will show total 6 methods for detection or identifying outliers using STATA. This is a STATA data file, and this is the ID of the observation, and this is the corresponding income. And from this data, I would like to find out, is there any outliers? We can do this by using either graphical or non-graphical method. First, I will show how can we identify outliers using the graphical method. The first method is box plot. So by generating box plot graph, we can identify whether there is a problem of outliers in the data or not. So to do this, under this command option, I have to type graph and then box. This box means actually box plot. So graph box and my variable. So my variable name is income. So graph box income. Now from this box plot graph, I can see these two observations here and these two observations here. These are far away from normal distribution and from this distance, in other words, from this distance. So since these two here and these two here are far away from this distance, so this potentially a problem of outlier. However, the problem of the just box plot here is that it shows that these two observations and here is two further observations, but the identification of observations is not labeled here. So to know which observation exactly has this outlier, we can slightly modify our command. So this is the second method. So in that case, I can type graph and then box and then income. That is my variable. Then I need to type mark and then 1, m level, and then first bracket, and this is the observations identification number, and then closing up the brackets. There are two brackets, so the first bracket closing for this one and the second one is for this one. Okay, and then if I press enter, now it shows the exact observation number. So from here I can see the observation number 37 149 137 and 42. This particular observation is far away from normal distribution and is an indication of potential outlier. So if I just want to check this, so if I look at observation number 37 and 149, so this 37, so the normal value is 75, 45, 50, 60, but it says 175. Similarly, if I looked 149, so if I looked here, right, so you see that this is very extreme value, 180. So this particular observations has this outlier problem, and we can identify through this labeling of the box plotting. Our another method, graphical method, is using the histogram. So just type histogram and then my variable, that is income, and I'd like to see this based on frequency. So after the comma I can type frequency. So histogram, my observation name, variable name, and then comma frequency. Okay, so I think the mistake I have done here is that I need to write histo ace is a small letter. So again I'm typing histogram and then my variable income and then frequency. I hope this time it will be okay. So histogram, make sure this ace is in a small letter. And right, so you can see the output here. So this particular observations here and this observations here is that deviated from the normal distribution. So this is an indication of the outlier for this particular observation. Next, another, our last graphical method is the spike plot. So if I type spike plot and then my variable name, that is income, press enter. So here you see the two observations here. The two observations are outside the normal distribution, so this is an indication of the outlier. So far we have shown how can we identify outlier problem using a different graphical method. Now I will show two method that is actually non-graphical to identify outlier. So the first one, I'll use the command extreme, and for using this extreme command you need to install that code. So for that purpose, first you need to install it. So ssc and install, and this code is called extremes. So ssc install extremes. Now here it says that all files already exist and are up to date. That means I have already installed this command, so you don't need to reinstall it if you have already. But if you don't have, then after running this command, this extreme command will be installed. This code actually installed in your STATA software. Now since this extreme command is already installed here, so I can now use this command. So the best thing is using the interquartile range. So under the command you need to type extremes and then your variable, that is income, and comma, and then IQR, that is actually interquartile range. So you can define different interquartile range here. By default it is 1.5, that is the cutoff point, but if you like, you can change this to 2, 3, whatever, but the normal practice is using the 1.5. and then if I press enter, I will get this observation number 4237 and 3749, and this particular observations, these values, this actually indicates that these values are actually 150% higher than interquartile range. So these are the indication of the outlier problem, and you can see this problem occurs for this particular observation number 4237 and 149. The last method that is also non-graphical method for identifying outlier using the Z score. So using the Z score, we want to see if my value is away from two standard deviations. Sometimes other researchers say three, but normal practice, or you can find it as a two standard deviation as a standard. So I want to see any values I have from two standard deviation from the mean. So if any values I have from two standard deviation of mean, there is a potential problem of the outlier. So to identify that, I need to type under the command option eigen, and then I need to create a variable. So I'm giving this a name of standard deviation of income. So this is the name of the new variable. And then I need to find out standard deviation. So after equal sign, you need to type std, and in the bracket you need to put your variable name, that is income. Closing up the bracket, press enter, and it says that some values has generated already. So if we looked here, so these are standard deviation. However, these are not shorted, so we need to short this one. So what I do, I need to short it. So under the command, type short, and then you put your new variable, that is standard deviation of the income, and then this has been shorted from the smaller to the higher. Now, if you consider 2, so if this is the absolute value, so in both cases you see this observation number 42 and 137, this are minus 2.7 and minus 2.42, and then if I look here, this is fine, this is up to 2, and then it is again higher than 2, right? Observation 3749. So this is 6 and this is 7. So the rule of thumb is that all the values should fall within 2 standard deviation of means in either direction. And you see here, it is away from 2 standard deviation. It is also away from 2 standard deviation. So this 7.02, this actually means that this particular observation's value, so that is 180, this actually almost 7 standard deviation AF from mean. So definitely these two, observation number 3749 and also observation number 42 and 137, these are the indication of outlier. So in this way, we can, both using the graphical and non-graphical way, we can find out the outlier. Thank you.